Hey, it's Matt from the Grain Arcade, back playing some more Farming Simulator 15 here at Westbridge Hills. We got our field mode here, and now we're ready to start tedding this thing. Now, this process, I've never seen this process, here locally. Now, I'm sure they may do it, out towards some of the bigger ranches or something like that. But most of the farmers around here that have cattle that get hay, they don't do this process. What they do is they just let the cut grass sit for a bit, and then they come back and rake it up and then bale it. What the tedder does is it tosses the grass, spins it, and makes it dry faster. And what that, it gets it up off the ground and gets the air up under it so it dries out faster. Now I think in this game, I'm not 100% sure, but I think you don't have to ted it, but you have to wait a little while for the grass to dry. And you can tell when it turns colors. I don't think it'll show it in our map here. That's not the right map. There we go. Where's the map? Here it is. Nope, this one. So you see it's blue there. It says fruit types. It says grass. They don't have a one for hay, so that's why it's got me wondering if it's actually true. See, now it says it's growing, so maybe you have to wait till the next growth stage or something, but I think you can let it sit on the ground and it will dry out eventually. I may be wrong, but this is what the tedder does. You drop it down and just tosses the grass. So let's see, cruise control on, and you can see it'll change color. See how it turns to a what color is that? Maybe a darker gray. It's not this bright green, fresh cut grass gray. It's a dried grass green. We'll just call it that, dried grass green. But yeah, this turns it, basically dries it out, turns it into hay. It's ready to go now, I think. All you have to do is rake it up and bale it. Turn the lights back on. Thing kind of scoots around when you turn too. You'll notice it kind of goes along with the ground too. If the ground is curved, it kind of bends and takes the form of the ground, so it's not straight and won't miss any. Said it's too bad, you can't have fields where the cows roam. Sure somebody will come up with a mod or something for that. The cows are always fenced in here, and yeah, I mean, you do need fences for cows, but there's more open areas where they have like barbed wire fences up. Hey, that would be something cool if you could build your own barbed wire fences. Now that they've brought customization to Farm Sim 17, you can put placeable buildings and sheds, storage stuff pretty much anywhere. That would be awesome if you could build like your own fences, because farmers, that's probably one of the more main things that a cattle farmer has to do, is to mend fences and put up new fences. And you could grass in a field and build a barbed wire fence. You could do it kind of like how you do the straps, the ratchet straps to hold stuff down on trailers now. You could walk up to a fence post, with your barbed wire in hand, and click on, put the little hand on the fence post and click it on there and have a little action where it nails it to the post, the barbed wire to the post. I may be stretching it, but I mean, that would be pretty cool, I think. So shout out to Giants. There's an idea for something in the future. I wonder if there's a place where you can go to recommend stuff. I'm gonna have to look that up later. I got a ton of ideas. I mean, there's so much in the world of agriculture that you can do now, or that that they have been doing. Not that you can do now, but that you can do, that you could apply into Farming Simulator. I hit my microphone there. I mean, why not get into horses? horses are a part, you know, of ranches and farms now. You could even do a cattle drive if you wanted to. You know, since you have horses, you could saddle your horse and unsaddle the horse and put them in the stall, clean out the stalls. I mean, a lot of people might say, "Hey, you're stretching it a little bit there. You don't want it to get too realistic." Well, no. I mean, it's a farming simulator, right? Let's expand it. Let's make it greater. Let's make it better. You know, you can't just keep going with the same stuff. So let's get horses, you know, to where you can, you know, shoe them and clean their stalls out and ride them around. You could ride them around, have cattle drives, and you know, take the hand action. Oh, what's the name for it? You know, the little target in the center of the screen where you can lasso a cow or a calf. You know, that could be a mission. You know, some a farmer might have a stray calf, and you could go on your horse and lasso it down and tie it up. And of course, you know, I don't know that you'd bring it back. I guess you could do it like a lead on Minecraft, but the mission would probably just be to lasso it, I'd imagine. Unless we greatly expanded the file size of the game. But yeah, one thing I'd really like to see is cotton. Get into the cotton harvest and rice. Rice would probably be the easier one, I guess, to do, maybe. I don't know, you'd have to have water with rice. You'd have to be able to build levees and break levees. So you'd have to have access to the dirt on the map to be able to build dirt up. Maybe not the main layer of dirt, but you could do it like you do, you know, you can pretty much dump anything anywhere on 17 now. So you could get dirt and make a levee. And then you'd fill it with water and plant, you know, have rice and then break the levees and then harvest your rice. And then, like I said, the cotton, you know, they could add cotton harvesters to the game. And there's a lot more that you can do. I mean, they have carrot harvesters now, peanut harvesters, vineyards. They have a harvester that drives over the vines. That's actually pretty cool looking. If you haven't seen that, go check it out on YouTube. I guess just type in maybe vineyard harvester. It's pretty cool. It kind of looks like the New Holland sprayer from 17, but it's thinner, not as wide, and it just drives right over the vines and shakes them, and that's how that works. Pretty neat. You know, I always pictured them, you know, picking the grapes by hand, you know, putting them in baskets and carrying them back to the deal. But, you know, I'm sure that's probably how they used to do it once upon a time. But now, you know, you don't think about that type of stuff, but, you know, they have to mass produce stuff like that, so they're going to need machines so they can do it faster. I mean, just like cotton. I mean, cotton used to be picked by hand, you know, back in the day, but now they have harvesters for that. They have machines and it does it so much faster, and they can put it in giant bales and it's just more efficient productivity wise. I wonder what else you could get into. Pretty sure they won't do like tobacco or anything like that. I guess you could do, well, cocoa beans, maybe. I guess they might have machines for that now. You know what they really should do? And this comes down to, like, you know, the regional part of what you can and can't grow. I mean, cocoa beans, for the most part, are grown in, at least in this part of the, you know, Western Hemisphere, are grown in South America. But there are no maps for South America. They really need to come up with at least like maybe 3 or 4 maps that are regional. And they could put one in America, one in South America, one in Europe, somewhere, maybe the UK or, you know, someplace like that. And, you know, they might be able to mod something like this now, but you could come up with the new crops that are only grown in that region. Like bananas, you know, you can't grow bananas in the north, you know, the European area, or cocoa beans up there. Just like, you know, soybeans are really dominant in America. And I don't know if they grow cotton anywhere else, but I know it's pretty dominant in the southern U.S. So, just something to think about for the future. You know, you can have, when you go to select your map, what you want to play, just pull up a map of the world and go to that specific part of the country. And, you know, if you had a map in Kansas, first you could select your country or continent, whatever. North America, South America, Europe, Asia. Then you could go, and maybe even South America, you know, I'll throw them in there too. There's continents, and Australia, we'll throw them in there. Only ones we won't throw in are the poles, like Antarctica and the North Pole, stuff like that, because, I guess it's called the Arctic. But I don't think they do much farming up there. They do a lot of mining, but not farming. So yeah, go to your continent, click on it, and then they'll have several maps. Like, okay, Goldcrest Valley for 17 is based in the Pacific Northwest. Great map. I'm doing a terrible job here. Let me get back straight. Great map. It's based in the Pacific Northwest. They do have farming up there. I know they do a lot of wheat and stuff like that up there too. It's really a booming logging region. So you could have that. And then you could come maybe down to the south, maybe we'll go maybe down to Mississippi or something like that, or Iowa or something like that, you know, somewhere in the center part of the U.S. where they do like the row cropping, like corn and wheat and rice and, you know, cotton and stuff like that. Then you could have a map like down in Texas, or, you know, maybe on like Texas, New Mexico area, where you could have like a ranch with cattle and, you know, horses and stuff like that. And they could even expand the logging part, you know, to like swamp loggers and stuff like that. That's a great show. And then, you know, you could have a map out in California or somewhere out there, you know, where you could do like the vineyards and stuff like that. You know, you could become a specific farmer depending on what region you're in. It just, to me, it makes sense. That would be an awesome game. You could have a farm, and it wouldn't be limited like, you know, you can only have a farm there. No, I mean, you could, since there's several game saves, you could have a wine farm, a grape farm, with, you know, with vineyards, stuff like that. You could have a ranch with cows and stuff like that. Then you could have a row crop farm, you know, somewhere else in America. And then have a logging company up in the Pacific Northwest. So many possibilities here. I mean, you could just have several different maps, you know, depending on the region, instead of including it all on one map. Not that it's not convenient to have it all on one map. But I just think that would be cool. So they can make additional maps like that, but the native maps, it would be nice to have the native maps like that. Another thing they could introduce is planes. That would be so cool to fly a crop duster over the crops. Or have a logging helicopter. They have logging helicopters that lift logs out of places and drop them down. I think that'd be cool. You'd fill up on your what you're spraying with a crop duster, you know. And then when you run out, you go back to the landing strip and land and fill up again and take back off and go back to the field that you were dusting and dust it. That would be awesome. They're going to need a lot of work on their physics, though. Physics and graphics, definitely. But yeah, for right now, I'm content and happy that they expanded. You know, they got soybeans and they got sunflowers. I mean, that was a step in the right direction, you know, adding more crop. Hopefully they'll add more crop, you know, in the future. I'm definitely going to have to find their website and see if there's a place where you can recommend stuff. I've thought about, you know, actually going in and developing and modding. Of course, I don't know. You're limited on kind of what you can do now if you do it for the console too. And I would like to do it for the console too, because, you know, if you want to make something great, make it available across all the platforms. That way you get the entire user base of the game. I guess you could mod it and do it on PC first, and then if they wanted to, they could do it as a DLC. But yeah, bring more crops, bring more functionality to the game, you know. Alright, I'm going to lift this up. Got to go back and... Well, let me lower it. There's some right there. Can I get it? Yep, I got it. Okay. Lift this up and go back down to the end of the field here. Got this end done. So this is already... Technically, you could run over this with the baler and bale it as it is now. But you got to think that baler is maybe as wide as this tractor. So can you imagine how many passes that would be to go back and forth with a baler? I want to turn my cruise control off. There we go. I wonder why I wasn't going nowhere. Alright, so we're just about done with tedding. But yeah, you definitely need to windrow it, because, I mean, you think about the tedders, you know, real wide, the windrows real wide. There we go. And almost not wide enough. I don't know if I'm going to make this whole pass or not. Nope, I'm going to have to go back just a little bit there. I don't think I can get that all in one. Maybe I can. Yeah, I probably should have just stayed over there like that. It's getting it. Kind of throws it out to the side there a little bit. And I'm missing there now, so. I'm going to go back down through here and just fix those little patches real quick. So yeah, we'll come back and get this windrowed and... I'm missing it all over the place now. Let me just keep it down. There's a little patch over here I missed. Get that big area there. Whoa, back up. That thing doesn't lower very fast. Thought it would be down by the time I got over it, but it was not. Whoops. Whoa. Nope. Okay, I turned it off. Didn't mean to do that. Didn't mean to raise it. There we go. Now we're in business. Alright, I got one more little strip down here somewhere. There's a little bit. And right up there, looks like it. Alright, so we'll wrap up this episode. That's the last of tedding. Basically, just drying out the grass. So it's ready to go as hay, and we'll get the rake down here and rake it up. And maybe do some baling the next time. So until then, remember, you reap what you sow. It's Matt from the Grain Arcade. We'll see you guys next time.